Good evening, and thanks to the organizer for my invitation. My presentation is regarding the role of coherent domains, the coherent mesoscopic bodies of the coherent fraction of water in the frame of the geomagnetic and of the geoelectromagnetic fields. Geoelectromagnetic fields, natural geoelectromagnetic fields, are the Schumann frequencies that are originated in the resonant cavity between the surface of Earth and the ionosphere. Pioneers in this topic are William Ross Addy, who observed that there is a window in amplitude and in frequency, a window for the interaction between electromagnetic fields and living systems. So we can say also between electromagnetic fields and water, because as St. Georgi said, the two matrices, neglected matrices of life are, yes, water, but also electromagnetic fields. Abraham Liebhoff, who suggested that ion cyclotron resonance could be an important, a crucial mechanism in mobilizing ions in living matter. And then Mikhail Jadin, who proved that motion of ion in aqueous solution depends on the geomagnetic field. Only recently, in 15 and in 16, my group published some papers where also the electrogeomagnetic fields are focused as actors of the motion of ions in aqueous solutions, and so in a cytoplasm and so on. In order to remember to ask the Jadin experiment, that is crucial because discovers the relationship between the geomagnetic field and the ion motion in aqueous solution. There is an electrolytic cell that is with a closed circuit without a battery, and there are two electrodes, platinum or gold electrodes, and there is the water where there is a solution. It is a solution, can be of calcium, magnesium, but also of amino acids. And when you apply an electromagnetic field tuned with the ion cyclotron resonance of the molecules that are solved in the cell, you can see a surprising emerging of ion currents. This is the facility we used in the hypomagnetic room of the National Council of Research in Italy, in Rome. It has walls made by 33 stages of permalloyed. So the geomagnetic field is fully shielded, and we provide both the substitute of the geomagnetic field and the alternate magnetic field tuned with the ion cyclotron resonance by means of this system. This system is monitored for temperature concentration of CO2. It is really an incubator with the engine outside of the room to avoid the interference between the electromagnetic field, the magnetic field generated by the engine and the experiment. So, when you connect the circuit to the electrodes, you have very weak currents that is in the order of 30, 35, 40 nanoampere for this setup, an electrolytic cell of about 3 centimeter per 3 centimeter. Excuse me. But when you apply you switch on the magnetic alternate magnetic field overimposed to the static magnetic field and in the same direction parallel to the static magnetic field that you provided, you can observe the emergency the rising of a peak of ion currents that has a lifetime in the order of half second, or also 1 second. It is surprising because the water is a bit distilled water. We, in the case of the Jardin experiment, main Jardin experiment, we have a solute acid, glutamic acid. There is a buffer, an acid buffer, to bring a pH to 2085, because the glutamic acid is a neutral at this pH, is a neutral polar molecule. Under 2 pH equal to, under pH equal to 1.9, glutamic acid becomes constituted by 2 separated ions. But up to 7 pH, glutamic acid is a polar molecule, an electric dipole. The current peak arising when the ion cyclotron resonance is switched on evidences first the glutamic acid becomes ionized despite it is exposed to a not ionizing radiation, because an electromagnetic field in the frequency of the ion cyclotron resonance is about normally 7-8 Hz depending on the static magnetic field that you provide. So 7 Hz is much far from the ionizing threshold of 10 to 15 Hz. The arising current has a lifetime in the order of the second, despite the Brownian force that overcome 10 to 8 times the Lorentz force induced by the alternated field. It means that the electric signal exceeds the thermal noise due to the KT, despite the Shannon-Hartley theorem. Since 2005, our research group exploited by an experimental point of view only, the Jardine effect, excuse me, in the hypomagnetic room, with reference to cytology, studying the inner ion currents in cells, inducing differentiation of murine, neural, and musculoskeletal stem cells, human epithelial cardiac stem cells, experimental with reference also to experimental oncology, modulating tumor cells, the pituitary derived corticotrope cells, and also recently other line of cells, with reference also to microbiology, modulating the biofilm mass of resistant bacteria. We published on Future Microbiology in 2015. I try now to give an example of investigation of the inner ion currents in cell, if I can. The other one, okay. Okay, as here, we have to. The induction of the motion of calcium molecules in cells is a vexata question. In the 18 years, an eminent distinguished researcher, as Liberty, was object of a campaign, and he lost all funds because their criticists said that he tricked the data. We applied a Helmholtz coil to a microscope, a fluorescent microscope, and we used a lymphocyte. You can see the organelles. It should be a mitochondrial organelle. And mitochondria storing calcium. We use a marker for calcium fluorophore, red marker. And you can look at the movie. See, paying attention to the intensity of the red in the organelles, and you can see that when we switch on the electromagnetic field, the ion cyclotron resonant magnetic field, that in the case is about 13.5 Hertz, you can see a motion from an escape from the mitochondria and from the organelles, and a centrifugal motion of the calcium. So we have to restart now. It is continuously going on. We can stop maybe in such a way. Ah, here. No, here there is. No. I went step. Stopped. Yes, but not at this moment. Ecco. At the beginning, there is the intensity of organelles is very high, and then decreases. Like now we are at the beginning. Giving an information regarding the motion of ion current in a cell. This effect was formerly yearly discovered by Carl Blackman of EPA, of US EPA, who in 1980 discovered that the ion efflux, calcium efflux, in chicken brains exposed to the magnetic field tuned with the ion cyclotron resonance, the efflux was enhanced by the exposure. Okay. We have to see. No, next. Okay. Further, other groups investigated the ULF and the amplitude modulated radio frequencies impact in cytology, studying DNA signals. The first reference is the paper published on the journal Cell Physiology by Marinelli and others of Bologna, from Bologna. And then there is regarding experimental oncology in vitro and vivo, there is the group of Zimmerman that has impressive results in trait, and also the group of Novikov, the pupil of Jadin, and in microbiology, in order to assess remote induction or inhibition of viruses, the case of the second publication of Montagnier in 2009. But what is the mechanism underlying such results in cell biology and medicine? For an answer, we look at the inner structure of water. The mechanism, the key, should be, in our perspective, the coherence in matter at room temperature. Water can be considered as a dynamic equilibrium between water single molecules and water clusters organized as microscopic aggregates. Cluster can be tuned in phase. Idem as to be, can be coherent. When clusters are coherent, they can be named coherent domains. Landau discovered the coherence in matter, but for a very peculiar condition, the condition of the superfluid helium, that is, excuse me, that is at 2.2 degree of absolute temperature. We can see at the enhancing the increasing of the coherent fraction, the decreasing of the incoherent fraction, depending on the temperature in the case of the superfluid helium between 1 and 2.2 absolute Kelvin degree. But in the case of water, we have that the range between the coherent fraction can increase is between 0 and 100 Celsius degrees. Water coherent domains at room temperature can be considered as spheres with a radius of about 14 nanometer and containing about more than 5 million of molecules. We got these data from the theory, from the quantum field electromagnetic theory, electrodynamic. Because once we formulate the Hamiltonian of this system, we can derive all this data. As Giuliano Preparata, a physicist, a distinguished physicist, Italian physicist, and Emilio Del Giudice, with the contribution of Peppino Vitiello and Boni Arano, did in 1985 and in the decade between 1985 and 1995. They originated from the oscillation of vacuum or from other solicitation from ambient due to the uncertainty principle that the variation of the energy multiplied the variation of time has to be more than the h divided to P, Greek P. The status of water is mainly the status, the combined status between the status of the ground state and the first excited state. The coefficient are can be determined and are .87 and .13. The oscillation between these two states give origin to the Mickey Mouse water. Unluckily, it is not possible to see Mickey Mouse, but in my computer is very, very clear. The origin is the superposition, the 5D state and the first 1S state. If you imagine this plane as a perpendicular plane and upon the sphere, you can imagine the image of Mickey Mouse. I look at my screen, but it is not transferred. This oscillation is the origin also of the hydrogen bond, because the hydrogen bond is the macroscopic evidence of the quantum oscillation that is able to link molecules in tetrahedral lattices or in a flickering tetrahedral structure. But the period of the hydrogen bond is very short. The lifetime is very short, in the order of 1.2 picosecond. The hydrogen bond arises, I already said, the quantum difference of energy between the ground state and between the first excited state is a dot for the water molecules is dot is 12.06 electron volt that in Hertz is in the order of 10 to 13. That is the reason for which the hydrogen bond flickers in less than 1 picosecond. See, these are clusters of liquid water, all oscillating at the same frequency, with the same phase. That's coherence. The origin of coherent domains, whatever is P, the probability of one interaction between the an electromagnetic field originated by the vacuum. When the electromagnetic field appears in a dense set of matter, in a dense aggregate of matters, it can interact with about 1,000 molecules of water, because lambda in the infrared spectra can be assumed in the order of 1,000 angstrom. So there is a critical number of density, of number density of the set of the aggregate where the electromagnetic field appears, for which the probability of interaction with the particles is a one, multiplied for the volume and for the density. In that situation, the electromagnetic field that appeared cannot escape this set of particles. So, in a short time, a large electromagnetic wave grows with the ensemble and of particles. And also, particles are attracted because there is a force that is able to attract particles within a static magnetic field that is proportional to the gradient of the magnetic potential vector, the square, and is inverse proportional to the difference between the frequency of oscillation of the particle and of the water. So, not only the water molecules are attracted by the growing coherent domains, but also other molecules that are passing in the neighborhood. And this is the origin of a mixed coherent domain. The condition is that the frequency of the particles that is attracted, the difference with the of the its frequency from the frequency of water should be less than .026 electron volt. The mixed coherent domains include solute molecules that enter in the CD, sharing their energy and their entropy. I have to go on. The entropy of the coherent domain ideally is zero, because the situation of minimum of energy that is realized when the aggregate becomes coherent corresponds to a minimum of entropy. Since in the space of phases it corresponds to a single point instead to 5 million and more points. Entropy is proportional to the logarithm of the number of actual microstates. So we have one microstate against 5 million. When molecules in ACD reach the unison of phase, it assumes the same physical and also chemical behavior independently from their chemical structure. Each molecule in a water CD, a water molecule, but also another molecule, becomes indistinguished, even if it is not a water molecule. So, we have to, in the proximity of an interface, coherent domains become stable. And we can consider that the zone where the coherent domains become stable is the zone where the coherent domains are able to include the other particles in a stable way. So we can look at this zone as an inclusion zone from the point of view of the molecules that satisfy this condition. From the point of view of molecules whose frequency of oscillations is higher, it is really an exclusion zone. And from an experimental point of view, you can look at this zone where small spheres of plastic or other substances that are not hydrophile, that do not satisfy the upper equation, this equation. These small spheres are excluded, but in the coherent domain, the particles are included. And it is the reason for which, after iterated dilution, you can find again the particles that you supposed disappeared, because the coherent domain can release, after the dilution, can release the captured molecules, and you find again the soluted molecules that you had before the dilution. It is the mechanism that is in which the coherent domain works as an egentropic engine, because when the system made by the coherent domain and the external particle that is attracted, when the system becomes a mixed coherent domain, the particle is included in the coherent domain, the entropy decreases. And so when the coherent domain that is able to store the every kind of energy coming from the ambient, because it's able to store heat in the clouds formed by almost free electrons of water in the excited state, the electron reach 12.06 electron volt, just half electron volt from the ionization. So there are many free electrons in the coherent domains. So the coherent domain shares this stored energy coming from the ambient in a disordered way, and release this energy in the electromagnetic degree of freedom to the particles when external electromagnetic field, like in the Jardin effect, induce the escape of the particles from the coherent domain. But the particles escape with the energy of the coherent domain. So they are able to overcome the KT threshold. Thank you.
Just one question, short question, if you have. Yeah, please.
In your research, you have integrated the notion of electrons, of photons, of electromagnetic fields. But have you considered as well the neutrino, which is a particle who represents a key in the comprehension of the universe and consequently the comprehension of the living? The neutrino compared to consideration only of photon and electron and electromagnetic fields.
Yes. No, I have the. No, I have. I have. The coherence is a status of matter, but also a status of energy. And he is regarding also complex systems. There is a coherence also in a society, because where the information is made, the role of the electromagnetic field trapped in the coherent domain is done by the meaning idea, the main ideas that are able to take united the members of the society, for an example. But also in the atmosphere, there are elements of coherence, also in meteorology. In the flight of birds, the formation of the clouds that are, the birds are able to form are subjected to the physical principle of reduction of energy to minimum. And when you have the reduction of the energy to minimum in a complex system made by many, many elements, you have a unique behavior. This fact reduces entropy. And the reduction of entropy release free energy, because free energy is the total energy minus the variation of entropy multiplied for temperature. If the variation is negative, minus multiplied minus, it becomes an increase. So the free energy increases. Another example is in the case of the embryon. The embryon is an organism, a system, that is able to increase is its growth or is a growth by means of reduction of entropy, because all the materials included in this growth are reordered in a unique phase. So you can look at the point that in embryology, in the phase of the growth of embryon, you have the maximum of apoptosis, because the apoptosis is the target of the free energy of Gibbs energy that is released with the reduction of entropy.
Yeah, thank you, Livio. Thank you very much.